All right, so the next thing that we want to learn about is the activation functions and how we can change the activation functions to deal with the unstable gradients problem. So what happens is, why this is called accelerating, what is accelerating and non-accelerating activation function comes from this. So if you have a sigmoid activation function, right, this is the curve that you have. And as you can see, after a while, whatever your number is, whatever your input is, as long as it's higher than a certain value, it's going to be 1. So you're going to get, if your values are getting really high, you're going to get 1 for whatever you input. So that's why we're saying that here it's saturating. Same for the negative values. If you have values that are very high here and a lot of them, then you're going to saturate at -1. So 1 and -1 and 0, then you get 0, are saturating here. And that's why they are causing problems, or that's why we call them saturating activation functions. And non-saturating activation function is, for example, is ReLU. So why is that not saturating? Well, again, you might say, okay, but it's saturating for negative values, but for positive values, it's a linear line. So then it's never going to saturate. It's just going to keep going and going. There have been some improvements on the ReLU or rectified linear unit activation function to also not making saturating when it comes to negative values. So let's talk about them one by one. So for example, you have leaky ReLU. Leaky ReLU is, you know, it again is the same. It's linear in the positive inputs, but for negative things, for negative inputs, it has some sort of slope here. And this slope is dependent on the parameter alpha. So you can make the slope very strict and linear, or you can make the slope a bit more gentle and going more slowly. So depending on the parameter A, you can change it will never be saturating again, right? Because it's always going to keep going with a certain slope, but you can determine that yourself. So this is another hyperparameter then you have to decide. But what they did, because they didn't like this, is to use randomized leaky ReLU. So what they did is, for the parameter A, then you need you choose a random number and you keep that random number for your training. But they also didn't like that. So on top of that, they came out with parametric leaky ReLU. So what happens is then alpha is set as a trainable parameter. And this parameter is learned during training to find out for this specific problem and network which value of alpha is the best. Next one was exponential linear unit is a little bit more different. So again, it has this nice little linear line when the values are positive, but when they're negative, it has this a little bit more of a different exponential graphic here. Again, this is determined by alpha. This exponential curve is determined by alpha. And of course, when things are like that, you're going to have more changes on top of it. So you have the scaled ELU. Scaled ELU, what it does is it lets the network train and normalize itself. So then you have self-normalization. This is actually a activation function that works very well and is set to outperform many of the others, but it has some limitations on how you can use it. I don't want to go into the specifics right now because I feel like those things are more like checkboxes that you need to fill. So I will add those details in the summary notes. Okay, so as I said, there are rules to working with ReLU or scaled ELU. And after that, basically, this is still an ongoing research progress. There's still a lot of work being done on it. Recently, I heard that there is one called GELU, Gaussian Error Linear Units, and I'm sure there will be more in the future. But basically, you just need to know that to not have the vanishing gradient problem or the exploding gradient problem, you have to choose the correct weight initialization technique with your correct activation function. And the best activation functions are the non-saturating activation functions like the ReLU and ReLU's friends here. But specifically which one to use, normally the advice is to start from ReLU. maybe Gelu is already there. Maybe people will tell you to start from Gelu now. But what I know is you have to start from Selu first, given that you are fulfilling all the requirements to be able to use it. Then work your way down and see which one works better for you. But for specific advice, I will again add this information to the summary, because again, this is just something that, you know, you would have to check the boxes for, and not really something that you can intrinsically learn. It's kind of like you need to learn it by heart in a way.